listen up. Hey, good job. All right, we got one left. You should be treating today like the day before a game, just like we just did a walkthrough. All right, you go home, get a good meal in you, get some rest, come back out here at 2 o'clock and we hook it up one last time, all right, for spring. You guys have given great effort every practice. There hasn't been one practice that, and you guys know I would tell you if we came out here and wasted a day. All right, you got better each and every day. You get one last opportunity to come out here and scrimmage in front of the fans, and it'll be a fun day tomorrow. Thanks.
Quick feet. Good. Now, Tanner, same thing. Don't get moving that way, right? Stay right there. You hop. Don't hop.
I think the coaches shared the same excitement. You know, I know I couldn't sleep last night, and neither. I mean, we were in here at, you know, 4:15 this morning, ready for it to get started. So, really excited. You know, I thought the day went as good as a first day can go. I mean, I told them, you know, last night in our team meeting that, you know, we're going to grade them on their effort and enthusiasm. They came out here and had great effort and a ton of enthusiasm.
All right. Bring power with it. We got little arm pads, all right, we can actually punch. We're not punching through the bag. You're going to visualize like you're going 4 inches through it. So we're actually moving the guy. Here we go. Ready, sit it.
You know, in college football, when you think about it, you don't get a lot of time on the field with your players, you know, because, you know, you get 15 days in the spring, that's it. And then now, you know, after Saturday, we don't put a ball on the field all summer long. We can't be out there. It's fall camp and the season's here the next time we get to be out there.
Spring ball is when you bond. That's the bond you're gonna have and take in the season. That's when you get to know the guys and just form those deep kind of bonds that are gonna make you a great team in the fall. The coaches have been telling me through spring that they need me to be a leader. They need me to step up, and the fact that they look to me for that is, it's an honor really, because leading a great group of guys like this and just being able to help in any way I can, I mean, that's the utmost honor that they trust me with that.
For us as a team, what it allowed us to do were really one simple point. It's like a road game. I mean, our kids actually had to get dressed in a locker room, get on a bus, even though it was a 20-minute trip, and go to a field that's not theirs. So it was a perfect example to get a young team some experience about what it's like to be on the road. And that's a great deal. Like I said, all the way across the board. We've had kids up front, you know, that are just kind of growing into the program, right? And, you know, like Chase Allen's an example at linebacker. He's been a leader before here, he'll continue to. That's in his DNA. But he's also taken the time to make sure he's doing things right on his own end before he's trying to lead others.
For spring ball this year is a big chance for us to meet the coaches and see what they're about. We saw them during conditioning and stuff, winter conditioning, but that you really don't know a coach until you're on the field with them and understand what he's all about. A lot of it this year was a lot more fast-paced than we've had it. We switched up some how things are done with team. Team was spread out throughout the practice, but last year was kind of more towards the end.
Yeah, I mean, if you go teams, we'd have two different colored jerseys on our sideline. You would have two different colored jerseys still.
That's what they've done. I would say, you know, but the same color.
Yeah, but I'm saying, would you call the D, obviously, on both? I mean, you can still manage that.
It's a lot of fun, you know. I think that it's it doesn't feel like a job. You know, it's something that I've always dreamed of doing. I didn't know when that day would come to be a head coach. You know, I've been a head coach in high school, but at the college level, it's definitely rewarding, especially being here at my alma mater where I played and so many memories and, you know, have so much passion for this place to be the head coach and be put in charge. It's definitely a dream come true.
I thought about one winning time too, being a like a third down challenge. Like we're gonna do five plays at different third down areas, and whoever wins, you know, you gotta get at least three stops, or your offense, you gotta get at least three conversions, and then there's something on the line for it too. Whether we like you're off and you know. A defense wins, offense, you got a full gasket right now. You know what I mean? Like, tell them what's on the line for it right now, type deal. Can hard to sleep, blood is in my dreams. Something's killing me, trying to figure it out. Nothing better to do when I'm stuck on you. I'm still in here trying to figure it out.
Practice is practice, right? You're always continuing to get better. We're putting them in situations, putting them under the pressures of the game. Now it kind of all displays itself, and there actually is a scoreboard. So it's another part of the growth. You have to do these things. They're not a nuisance. So what you want to see is how are kids going to react to that when there is more of a crowd. There is more of a, hey, we're keeping score now. So it's another developmental phase to see where we're at. It's a beautiful way to see after the end of 15 practices, here's where we stand.
I'd say it was harder. It was tough this year. There was a lot of, it was up-tempo the whole time. That's one thing that we had last year, but we kind of upped the ante a little bit. It's very up-tempo. We're always moving. There's always something you're going to be doing. There's never any point in practice where you don't have a job.
Can we hook it up one last time, all right, for spring? You guys have given great effort every practice. There hasn't been one practice that, and you guys know I would tell you if we came out here and wasted a day. All right, you got better each and every day. You get one last opportunity to come out here and scrimmage in front of the fans. And it'll be a fun day tomorrow, right? But you got to take it serious. You got to be locked in. Anytime that we come out here, that's what we said. You don't know who's watching every rep. You have to take it serious. You have to have great focus, and it's got to be all in.
You can't waste any practices. All 15 practices, every meeting, every minute you can be with those guys means a lot. We've got to get better. Our attention to detail. You know, I tell them all the time, and I always believe this as a head coach. You know, it's there's no magic formula. You know, the schemes, all that. We've got plenty of scheme to win games. You know, it's going to come down to loving each other, creating a culture of being a team, playing hard. A football play is 4 to 6 seconds long, and you got to go as hard as you can for your teammate next to you.
Have a day, deuces.
Yeah.
To sum it up, I think Coach Hill set a great environment. I think the kids have set a great attitude, so you got a chance for learning to happen when you put those three components together.
Going out with a bang, that's the real biggest thing. I mean, it's my last year, and having an impact is what I want to be. That's what I want to do. I want to have a bigger impact than I've ever had before as a leader, as a player, as anything I can be.
We haven't beat a big school since I've been here. We've come close every single year, so it'd just be nice as a senior to finally beat the bigger school.
No one's bigger than this team. And we've got a short window of time that you get to play college football. And I really feel like our guys are getting a sense of that. You know, coming from us, coming from the coaches, what it means to me, I want it to mean the same to them. I want them to come back in 10 years from now and love being a Saluki.